Drums, please.
What's up, YouTube? It's your boy hollowpoint33 here, just coming back at you with a little bit of more Madden online gameplay. First of all, I wanted to thank everybody that who watched the first video. I know it wasn't a whole ton of people, but hey, you got to start somewhere, right? So let's get right into it. So I'm the Carolina Panthers, as I normally am, with Killer Cam, and we got ASL 23, who is the New York Football Giants, so the Super Bowl champ. So the game starts off a little slow and trying to feel, it's a feeling out process like it normally is, like trying to see what you can get away with, see what you can and can't stop. Excuse me there. We hit him with a little compressed set action, a little strong close. So he tries to try his run game out, get a little broken tackle. It's decent gain there. So we figure, hey, let's keep this party rolling. So try to hit shot guy in the flats, but he does his best volleyball impression and spikes the ball down. So anyway, it is now third down, and he forgot to guard Stewart over the top, and that was a mistake. What a pass right there. What a catch and run. Touchdown, Carolina Panthers. Boom. Just right out the gate. Thinking you're going to be all right? No, you're not going to be all right. That was beastin'. Luckily, the Giants recovered the ball. So now it's just second and long here. And, you know, nobody comes back from a hit like that. I think we should do some sort of, you know, make sure he's okay. Does he get a concussion test after that? I don't know. So second down, he throws it away. And so we figure he can't, you know, he getting under duress with that heat. So we figure, hey, let's send some more. So third down, he drops back and he throws a ball. And it's actually a good ball. Too bad he dropped it, though. So brings him to fourth down. And why he is going for it here is so early in the game at the 15-yard line, I don't know. But, hey, good for me. He throws a 6-yard pass. He needed 7 yards. So, you know, my ball at the, you know, 21-yard line. I don't know. So, we hit him up with a little weak side zone play here. And then we hit him with a dive up the middle. Normally, when I get in the goal line, when I get under 10 yards, man, I ain't trying to do nothing fancy. You know, I'm either going to run the ball up the middle. If I get you within a 5, first and goal, I'm running the ball. You can cash that in. You have to stop the run. They have to stop it. So we score pretty easy right there to go up 2 touchdowns. More thanks to him than my offense or my defense. I can thank my defense. Either way, you know, sometimes you it's not really – super good to go for it on fourth down, but that's neither here nor there. So, all right, we got a second and 7 here, and he's in his version of the strong close, and he decides to try to take off. I don't know why, but hey, to each his own. You want to try that? You want to get his inner Vic on? Go for it. So anyway, you know, third and manageable, and he hits me upside the head with this effing sweep. And I hate it when I get caught in between my adjustments and I click on, next thing you know, I got the defensive tackle going the other way, way out of the play. So he hits me with a real nice game right there, you know, puts him in position to just ram it up the middle, fullback style, you know. So kudos to him for staying in the game and fighting up to that point. So, you know, he makes this field goal. No real surprise there. So, you know, first down on my end, and my stubbornness won't let me not try to run the ball. So that's what happened there. I tried to hit him with the counter. He did a good job there. The Giants' defensive line is ridiculous. So it's you know, you got Pierre Paul. Yeah, Canty, OCU New York. I mean, they got about five defensive linemen there. You could just say, "Here, I'm gonna take this. I'm gonna put pressure on them. Y'all do the rest. Linebackers, y'all just do the rest. You don't need to clean up because we got it." So, anyway, got the ball here, and LaFell just catches a lovely ball. A lovely ball here. So, first and 10, we got Stewart on the in the flats here. Oh, whoop! Oh, come on, get your block in, baby. We could have had that to the house. So, good catch by Stewart, by the way. He's underrated as catching out of the backfield. He's not the best one on the team. I think Goodson is, but he ain't bad. I take him over D. Williams and Goodson just simply because of he less likely to fumble the ball than the previous two. That being said, he is stuffing the counter, and I just refuse to run something different. So we got 2nd and 9. We hit Geddes out on the flats here. You know, get him about a 3-yard gain. Nothing too big, but positive yards better than 0 yards or even worse, negative yards. So you got 3rd and manageable right here, what I always like to call it. Is you know, we notice he's in some sort of man D, what it looked like at first, and yes it is. And then we hit, oh, that's a dot right there. So got 1st and goal here, and like I said, I'm gonna run it up the middle. If I'm close, I'm gonna try to run it. Once you show me you can stop it, then I'll do something else. And he actually did a pretty good job of holding it to like 3 yards right there. So we got a 2nd and goal, and we attempt to throw him off, and then with the draw, but apparently the Giants were in the huddle with us, and they knew it was coming. So hit him up in the backfield. He lost those 3 yards he just gained. And what we normally like to do in that instance is take him to the barbershop for a smooth fade with the part in the middle. Yeah. So, you know, I'm up 21-7. I'm feeling pretty good. So the defense is just bringing the heat. He's in the oven. I mean, he's in the oven at 350, you know, 15 minutes. You know, just he's going to be we roast him. So, you know, we bring it from the right and bring it from the left and we bring it from the middle. He actually gets a good dot right there on a little slant route. So that was good on him. Actually, one of the first downs, I believe, besides that long run. So defense is doing pretty good. I figured I'd change it up right here and do some max coverage D. Here it's not really fag D right here, fellas. It's max coverage D right here. It's only fag-y if it's 1st and goal, hence the fag. Just a little tidbit for those of you who didn't know. And it's not fag-y because it's a sissy D. And so that's my little 2 cents on that. So anyway, back to the game. He's, you know, scrambled around only for not. So this time I sent about 2 people there and got a lot of coverage out in the field. He overthrows it. He saw that heat coming, and it wasn't really heat, it was more perceived heat, but he saw it coming, and he had that timer going off. So I send 3-3 again. He actually gets a good ball there to the tight end over the middle. Here we go, 4th and short. I mean, I don't mind going for it here. This is manageable, you know, right at midfield. You know, you can't kick, and you don't really want to punt it right here down. To score 2 touchdowns, so you know you want to give it a go. And he, I don't know if I'm throwing it deep on like that in 4th and 2, but you know that's his decision. He decided to do it. Cam, just sometimes, you know, he's either feast or famine. He's gonna throw some dots, and he's gonna throw some ducks. That's just Cam. You just gotta, you either love him or you hate him, you know. And you know, I'm a huge Cam Newton fan, and he come in for the pressure there, knockdown. So as I was saying, I'm a huge Cam Newton fan, you know, Auburn University War Eagle. Yeah, so that's why I roll with the Panthers, man. They got probably one of the more balanced teams in the game, and that's why I roll with them. The defense is tough, you know, with them linebackers. And the defense backfield ain't that bad. Gamble is a really good safety cornerback. Godfrey is a really good strong safety. And then you got either Butler, keep Munnerlyn off the field if necessary. If I got to do a picket sign, oh, see, there go one of the dots that I was telling you about right there on that corner right. That was a dot. So, for first and goal, of course, and, you know, I wanted to get him thinking that I was going to do hit him up with a fade route in the barbershop, but instead I started to go for the draw, and once again, just no trying to do that. Canty just beasted my safety, or my center, sorry about that. So I tried to hit him on his steward on an angle route, and he had that covered pretty well. So, you know, tried to take him to the barbershop for another fade route, but he dropped back and he said, you know what, I already got a fade with the part in the middle on one another. So he had played some really good defense right there. If you want to see how to stop the fade, you see that one. That was a good stop right there. He had two people on him. So I ended up taking a field goal, and you know, he's got the ball back in a familiar position at the 15-yard line, and boom, there goes some more pressure. You know, just sack lunching him all day. I mean, I think that was our ham and cheese sack lunch right there, with the Doritos in it and the snack pack. You know, y'all know what I'm talking about. So, you know, I'm hitting with all kinds of pressure. I mean, it's getting really hot in here. You know, it's just super. Then he thinks it's coming, and he just tosses it. Oh, no. Just we knocking stuff down. Right? I would have loved to get picks in this game, but I think I like the pressure and moving it off your spot better, making them uncomfortable. Boom, another sack. Lunch, God, to be more careful, man. I think they need blocking practice after this. That's immediately following. Blocking practice, New York Giants. All right, so there's no way he should be screaming like that just to get open. All right, once again, fourth and super long, and he decides to go for it. Here we come again. Boom. Just, we get in there, man. That's what we do. So, I mean, we get up, just running the ball. I mean, we if you've noticed these two games, there is nothing super secret about my offense. If I can run the ball against you, I'm going to run it, and I'm going to try until – there is no reason for me not to try, you know, especially if me being up gives me a chance to possess the ball. If I got the ball, that means you don't have the ball. And I think that's the theory that I roll with for the most part. So, you know, it's third and goal here. We're going to try to get in there. You know, see what happens. Give me a little motion here, back up. Oh man, I gotta fix that, because that was a nice, really nice route by Shockey. And there goes the dagger, folks. So thank you once again for watching. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Like it if you want. I want to get about 50, maybe 50 likes, maybe. But yeah, thanks for coming, and keep coming back, man. I'm gonna keep putting it out there, and I'm gonna keep coming. So thanks for watching, and talk to you later. Peace.